Over rising tensions with Kosovo. President Aleksandar Vučić said he would take all measures to protect people and preserve Serbia. Serbia's defense minister has been visiting an army base in Raška near the border with Kosovo. Kosovo declared independence from Serbia in 2008, but Belgrade has refused to recognize it. The current escalation is believed to be unprecedented for recent years. Well, I'm joined now by Dr. Helena Ivanov in Belgrade. Dr. Ivanov is Associate Fellow at the Henry Jackson Society. Thank you very much for joining us. So what's the reason for this recent escalation of tension?
Well, you know, the flare-ups have been happening basically since the summer when a row began because of the car license plate problem, whereby Kosovo basically requested all of those who've registered their car in Serbia to re-register their car to Kosovo registration plates. On top of that, we had a flare-up regarding the travel issue documents. But the most recent one, which basically caused the Serbian government to raise their troops to the highest alert, is the arrest of a Kosovo former policeman, Dejan Pantelic, who was recently arrested. And the Serbs are basically demanding his release. They have also abandoned all the Kosovo institutions. And we've seen in the recent days that barricades have been erected across Kosovo. And now we're seeing the latest tension.
And when we talk about high alert, what exactly does that mean?
That basically means that should any further escalation happens and should we require a very prompt response, the troops are basically going to be ready. That means putting your troops on the highest alert, basically meaning that they can have an immediate response should the need arise for that.
Considering the historic ties, has there been any response from Russia to all of this?
At the moment, I believe that when it comes to Russia, definitely we can expect that Russia will be siding diplomatically speaking with Serbia, obviously, because Russia has not recognized Kosovo as an independent state, among other countries that haven't done that either. However, I'm very doubtful that any further or deeper or more substantial involvement on behalf of Russia is going to happen, primarily because Russia is currently occupied with the invasion that it started in February in Donbas region.
Now, your specific area of research focuses on the relationship between propaganda and violence. I just wonder to what extent has propaganda played a role in this situation?
I absolutely think that propaganda is crucial. And I don't just mean, you know, the latest headlines that we could have seen, which obviously are trying to spark tensions. I'm talking about basically the discourses and narratives that have been promoted throughout the 1990s, but then also in the aftermath of the war. I think across the former Yugoslavia region, we can see, you know, discourses that are definitely contributing to tensions. We can see that little to no effort has been made to really reconcile the differences and tensions that we've seen in the past. And also, it hasn't been an exception for politicians in the region to basically use nationalist card and play it anytime they see it fit for their own personal gains. So unfortunately, in the entire former Yugoslavia region, and particularly when it comes to Kosovo, propaganda has been rather crucial over the last few decades.
Just finally and briefly, what are the possible solutions? What can de-escalate these current tensions, in your opinion?
Well, I think, you know, hopefully the EU and KFOR forces will encourage both sides to sit down and negotiate. I think, you know, on one hand, the release of some of the people who've been imprisoned, but also the removing of the barricades would be the two crucial steps necessary for the de-escalation. But I think the international community's involvement will be crucial to get the two sides at a negotiating table and some kind of a feasible deal that's acceptable to all.
Dr. Helena Ivanov, thank you very much. Here in the UK, Merseyside police are questioning two people in connection with the fatal shooting of a woman at a pub in Wallasey on Christmas Eve. A 30-year-old man has been arrested on suspicion of the murder of Ellie Edwards. A 19-year-old woman was detained on suspicion of conspiracy to murder. Our correspondent Fiona Trott has this report.
A beautiful angel. That's how Ellie Edwards has been described by colleagues. A beautician who was